हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, फील द लाईफमध्ये मी सचिन आणि आज आपण बघणार आहोत CRPC चा स्टेटमेंट्स अँड कन्फेशन हा टॉपिक. तर चला सुरू करूया. स्टेटमेंट अँड कन्फेशन्स सेक्शन 164 ऑफ CRPC लेट डाऊन द प्रोसिजर फॉर रेकॉर्डिंग ऑफ अ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ विटनेस अँड कन्फेशन ऑफ अन ॲक्युज बाय द मॅजिस्ट्रेट. इट ऑथोराइजेस ज्युडिशियल मॅजिस्ट्रेट अँड मेट्रोपॉलिटन मॅजिस्ट्रेट फॉर सच रेकॉर्डिंग so as to understand what precautions are need to be taken by these magistrate while recording statements and confession. The provisions of section 164 shall be read with section 281 of CRPC along with the provisions of chapter 1 para 17 to 19 of a criminal manual. Provisions of section 164 of CRPC. These provisions laid down the procedure for recording of statements and confessions. The analysis of this section gives following points. First, recording by magistrate. Section 164 of CRPC empowers any judicial magistrate or metropolitan magistrate to record statements and confessions. It will be immaterial whether or not such magistrate has jurisdiction in that case or not. However, such recording must be made during the investigation and before the commencement of inquiry or trial. It is also provided that no confession shall be recorded by a police officer on whom any power of magistrate has been conferred. Second, magistrate to warn. It provides that before recording any confession, the magistrate must explain to the person making it that he is not bound to make a confession and that if he does so, it may be used as evidence against him. Further, the magistrate can record any such confession only if he is satisfied upon questioning that it is being made voluntarily. Third, no detention in police custody. If at any time before the confession is recorded, the accused states that he is not willing to make the confession, the magistrate shall not detain him police custody. Fourth, manner of recording confession. Section 164, subsection 4 of CRPC says that the confession shall be recorded in a manner provided in section 281 of CRPC. It must be signed by the person making it. So also, the magistrate shall make a memorandum at the foot of such record indicating that he explained that person that he is not bound to give the confession and if he gives it, it shall be used against him in evidence. Therefore, the confession appears to him to be voluntary. Fifth, manner of recording statement. Section 164, subsection 5 provides the manner in which statement of the witness shall be recorded by magistrate. It lays down that the statement under this section shall be recorded in such manner provided for recording of evidence examining in chief as is in the opinion of the magistrate best fitted to the circumstances of the case. Further, the magistrate shall have the power to give oath to the person whose statement is being recorded. 6. Forwarded to the magistrate. After recording statement or confession, it shall be forwarded to the magistrate by whom the case is to be inquired into or tried. Provisions of manual. Chapter 1, para 17 and 18. Certain provisions have been made in criminal manual in the matter of recording confession. These provisions are made without flattering discretion of magistrates for their guidance. They provide as following. First, the accused should be taken before the magistrate for recording his confession and whenever possible before such magistrate who will eventually not try the matter. Second, the confession is to be recorded in open court and during court hours in ordinary circumstances. Third, it should be impressed on the accused that he is no more in police custody and the magistrate is not the police. Fourth, it should be made clear to the accused that he is not bound to make a confession, but if he makes it, that will be used against him in evidence. Thereafter, a period not less than 24 hours shall be given to him for reconsideration. Fifth, confession should be recorded in two parts. Part 1 should contain record of inquiry that pretends to giving him more than 24 hours for reconsideration, while Part 2 shall contain actual confession after being satisfied that it is made voluntarily. Provisions of Section 281 of CRPC. Section 164, Subsection 4 provides that confession of the accused shall be recorded in manner provided under Section 281 of CRPC. Thus, the provisions of Section 281 needs to be examined, which are as follows. First, memorandum of substance, if recorded by Metropolitan Magistrate. It is provided that whenever the accused is examined by Metropolitan Magistrate, the memorandum of the substance of such examination is prepared and signed by him in the language of court, which is now Marathi. Second, question and answers, if recorded by any other magistrate. It is provided that when the accused is examined by any magistrate other than Metropolitan Magistrate or by session judge, the whole of the examination including all the questions shall be recorded in full by the presiding judge himself, or when he is disabled to do so, under his presence and superintendence. Third, in the language of court, it is also laid down that if practicable, the record shall be in the language in which the accused is examined. If it is not practicable, it should be in the language of the court, that is Marathi. Fourth, accused should be at liberty to explain or add. If the accused does not understand the language in which the record is written, it shall be shown or read over to him. He shall be at the liberty to explain it or add to it if desires so. Fifth, certification by magistrate or judge. It is also provided that the record shall be signed by the accused and by the presiding magistrate or judge, who shall certify under his own hand that the examination was taken in his presence and hearing, and that the record contains a full and true account of statements made by the accused.